We leave you now with a preview of the performance by American Karen Kadavy.
Sports Sunday has been sponsored by Michelob, so exceptionally smooth the night belongs to Michelob. Honda Power Equipment, lawnmowers, riding mowers, and portable generators made to last. And by the American Express card, don't leave home without it. Coming up next, the NCAA Basketball Tournament Regional Finals.
This is Katarina Witt, the world champion from Cincinnati, the Olympic champion from Sarajevo, and one of the truly important skaters in the world today. Seems to like Broadway music. She used West Side Story for her competitive number at Cincinnati and the World Championship, and here, of course, it's Maine.
Well, the rivalry between her and Debbie Thomas is going to be very, very interesting to create a very intense competition at the Olympics. glamorous girl she is. We've seen some great performances here at the World Tour of Champions. It's a wonderful start for this 15-city tour, which was so well produced by Tom Collins.
And how great it is to see these young skaters as they start the countdown to Calgary and the 1988 Winter Olympic Games. And now on behalf of Peggy Fleming, this is Dick Button saying thank you for joining us here in Hartford.
And here he is, dazzling in the short program of the competition and plenty good enough in the final free skating program to defeat Brian Boitano and Alexander Fadeev. His fourth try at the World Championship and finally the gold. For the world champion, Brian Orser of Canada. And we'll be back after this from your local station.
Skating for the United States and winner of the silver medal in the World Ladies Figure Skating Championship, won't you welcome Debbie Thomas.
Tell me, folks, does that look like a former world champion and a silver medalist this year in the ladies' singles competition? Who, me? Debbie Thomas.
Next skater is Wanda Beazle from the Barrier Bouncer Figure Skating Club.
Oh, excuse me, it's Wanda Beazle.
Well, I guess Wanda didn't know that she had to be here by Saturday, so the ISU is allowing her to submit her routine a day late. She's an excellent competitor, and she's in fine condition. Walls jump, toe loop, half loop, half loop, half loop, oh, and she gets a fall, but it wasn't on anything technically difficult, so I don't think that'll hurt her in the final standing. And the grace and beauty of ladies' figure skating. Flower girls know what to do, whether to help her or not.
There is in this young lady much of a natural clown. Debbie Thomas. What a performer. What a competitor. What a star. We'll be back in Cincinnati with more special performances from the World Figure Skating Championships in a moment. If you love ballet and ice skating, you will love this performance by Klimova and Ponomarenko.
That's right, Tim. Those of you familiar with the ballet will know that you warm up at the bar, you rehearse, you perform, and you take your final bows.
probably wouldn't do it justice. It's more like an artistic creation. I've seen this so many times, and today it seems to have much more feeling, much more depth of emotion.
I agree with you, Scott. If they could only package this magic into a free dance, I think they could be the world champions.
An absolutely riveting performance by Mr. and Mrs. Sergei Ponomarenko.
Our next couple won the bronze medal. Please welcome Jill Watson and Peter Oppegard.
Here are the bronze medalists in the pairs, Jill Watson and Peter Oppegard of the United States, in their special performance.
I heard their coach talking about it earlier, and they're doing a tango. It's kind of a cross between ice dancing and pair skating.
They'll accept the first pretty face that comes along and make him a star.
It's so rare that we see pair skaters doing a tango.
Dancing cheek to chest.
Many people see this choreography, they wonder, when do these competitors have a chance to practice these exhibition performances?
Besides preparing for competitions, you always know that you have to be ready with some fantastic exhibition numbers. And in reality, you end up performing those more than you do the competitive numbers.
That's right. When I was competing as an amateur, I'd compete 5, 6, 7 times a year, but I'd exhibit up to 100 times a year. Strong to do that.
Peter Oppegard withholding nothing in this exhibition performance, and the crowd knows it. We'll be back with more from Cincinnati in a moment.
We introduce the 1987 World Ice Dance Champions from the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, Natalia Bestyomanova and Andrei Bukin.
The
world ice dance champion for the third time this year here in Cincinnati, Natalia Bestemyanova and Andrei Bukin. The American public here in Cincinnati, and it appears they have done so. The world ice dance champion, Bestemyanova and Bukin. And now the queen of the show, the world ladies singles champion, Katarina Witt. Regional Champion, the ravishing Katarina Vint. So for Judy Blumberg and Scott Hamilton, I'm Jim Ryan saying so long from Cincinnati.
CBS Sports Sunday has been sponsored by Michelob Light, superb taste and less filling beer. Mitsubishi Motors, experience the sensation of the full line of new cars and trucks from Mitsubishi. And by the Century 21 System, the largest real estate sales organization in America. Stay tuned as NCAA basketball continues with the women's championship game next on CBS Sports.